My heart's so cold, I think I'm done with ice. Birds. If I leave her, she gon' die. Well, bitch, you done with life.
Okay.
Better not pull up with no knife, cause I bring guns to fight.
Boom.
Say you got that sack, I got that sack. But ain't no ones of mine.
Nope.
And my little bitch say I'm getting too boo. I don't need like dubs of mine.
Alright.
What I look like with all them 20s?
Huh?
Know them hoes like how I'm coming.
Yeah.
What I look like with all this money?
Huh?
How I look having all these hoes? When I crack a smile, white gold.
Bling.
Yeah, I'm talking diamonds, froze.
Yeah.
Came from the bottom, toes.
Oh,
yeah.
Get it.
Back in, baby.
100.
That way they pay me a show.
Let's go.
It's probably some cap in my rap by the time this shit drop.
What is up, y'all? It is Miss Shayla, but you can call me Miss Shay. And today I have a how to customize a lace closure wig video. This is not gonna be a long video. It's gonna be straight to the point, so we're getting right into it. So you first want to wet the hair or the front of the hairline, just because it's easier to pluck wet hair than dry hair. It's easier to see when it's wet to me. You want to brush out back all the hair, so you're just gonna pull some hair out in the front. And plucking is easier to see than explain, so I'm gonna try to explain, then I'm just gonna let you watch the rest. First, you just be light-handed, and you don't want to stay in one spot or it will cause bald spots. You just want to move sporadically throughout the hairline. Basically, you don't want to stay in one place or it will cause bald spots, and that's just not cute. That's not the look we're going for. We're going for a more natural look. I didn't pluck too much on this one because it is a curly wig, and I just feel like curly hair should be a little more fuller in the front because it just makes it look more natural to me, at least. So as you can see, it's starting to thin out a lot. I'm taking the comb and I'm combing back the hair. That's just going to pull the loose hairs out of the way so I can see where I need to plug and where I don't need to plug. You can see the difference. Look at that difference, y'all. Once again, I'm taking a part in the front. Then you just start plucking. I like to pluck in the very front, and then I also like to go like actually into the hair so it doesn't be like a distinct line where it's plucked and then it's like for the back where it's just like not plucked. It just makes it look more natural if you bring it even further back from the hairline to me. And then you're just gonna take the hair that's actually in the front, you're gonna pull that back, and you're gonna pluck that just to give that more of a natural look because it is a distinct line. And as you can see, if you pluck behind the hairline, you see how it's like naturally just a gradient effect. It's not so harsh where you can tell where it's not plucked and where it is plucked. And as you can see from the previous clips, it was like some of the hairs weren't plucking the right way. Like it was breaking off, so it was leaving the knots in the very front, like on the very, very front. So I had to go back in and actually pull those knots out of the closure. Okay, next, this is just me getting ready to define the curls and put some life back into that wig because it was just too much. It was just too much going on. I needed to define the curls. Yeah, so this is just me. I had some conditioner in that water and I just conditioned it, finger combed it, and then I went in with a paddle brush. I brushed it out. The curls was beautiful. Then I just went in with some jelly soft curls because I didn't want anything too heavy to weigh the hair down. So that was like the lightest styling gel that I had. Just kept repeating this step until it was finished. Okay, this is me just getting into the closure. This is gonna show me styling it and how I, you know, do it. So I just wet the hair with the same conditioner water. I saturated really good. And then I just took the paddle brush and I detangled it. I took the same jelly soft curls, but I later end up using some Eco Styler because those curls are a little more frizzy than the ones at the bottom. So I don't know what was going on. It was just not holding a curl. I mean, it was holding the curl, but it was getting way too frizzy. So yeah. And this is just me getting ready to style it. I like to wear a middle part. I do sometimes wear a side part, but I'm more of a middle part type of person. Taking my bristle brush and I'm just flattening it out. You want to get that part nice and straight. You don't want it to be all lopsided. I mean, you can if you want even more of a natural, but I like a distinct straight part. Seeing that this side was a little full, so I just went back in and I started plucking just a little bit more. I just tweaked it here and there. This is just me getting ready to make the baby hairs. I take out the very front line of hair and I use my eyebrow razor and I just cut it into more of a diagonal look. You don't want it to be straight across because then the baby hairs might not lay right. So you want to cut it diagonally and you don't want to cut them too short too at first because you can't go back. So I'd rather have it longer than shorter. And then I'm just going in with my lighter body and I'm going to start styling the baby hairs and getting the part straight and everything flattened out. The baby hairs are too thick. I will pluck them some more because I don't like super thick baby hairs and I don't like super hard gel to the head looking baby hairs. I like my baby hairs to be brushed out after they're molded down. It just gives it a harsh effect. So yeah, this is the final product. This is what it looked like when it was wet and before I styled it and cut it a little because it was just too long. It didn't fit right for me. I don't know. I like maybe like bob length. The longest I'll go is maybe bra strap length for curly hair, because curly hair, like, it holds in heat and I get hot very easily, and I don't know, it just fits my face better too. As you can see, this is what I was talking about. I was laughing because it was just so much hair. It just looked so crazy to me. Like, I don't know. It was just something about it. I was like, not even feeling it. Like, I was like, yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to cut this. At first, I wasn't thinking I was gonna have to cut it, but when I put it on, I was like, oh yeah, I gotta cut this. So I don't really know. I'm not a professional. I'm gonna go put that out there. I'm not a professional cutting hair. I'm not a professional doing hair. This is just the way I do things. So yeah. I just cut it in a diagonal look. I wanted it to be more like a harp shape, heart shaped. So this is just me cutting it and getting it to the right length. And this is what it looked like when I first finished cutting it. It still just seemed too long to me, but it also was still pretty. I will be posting a video on how I install my wig. I'll be showing y'all with it on me and everything, because I still end up going back in and I still end up cutting it and getting it right the way I liked it. So be looking forward to that video, and I guess I'll see y'all next time. Bye.